welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Nebraska's staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk, and I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons, and I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Down at the 48. Oh, that was one beauty of an option by that quarterback.
No question. There was no hesitation whatsoever. Once he saw that hole, he turned it upfield and left everybody in the dust.
Quick out to his receiver, and he's taken down at the 42.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
It's second and four to go. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Two down. Check your D9. Mike.
Nice run there. So the halfback picks up the first down there with a 7-yard gain.
You know, there may have been a little bit of uncertainty there by the front seven. They did read the option. They knew it was coming. But they were just a step too slow to stop it from being a good game.
Open, incomplete.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over.
From the 35-yard line, it's second down. They'll bring him down at the 22.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
Around the 12-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Nice run, and he's brought down. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
It's first and goal. Ball on the eight. He's tackled at about the 7-yard line.
That brings up second and goal.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. He holds on to it and gets maybe 2 yards.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it third and goal.
It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out.
Two down. Check 59. Mike is 59.
Touchdown, Cornhuskers. So the halfback took it in for six.
Simple play call there by the offensive coordinator. Just give it to the back and let him find his way into the end zone.
He makes the PAT. So an 11-play, 74-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. Nebraska to kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. They come out on an empty backfield. And he just gets rid of it. It's second and 10. Ball on their own 25. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
You know, I talked to so many college quarterbacks who have gone on to be very successful in the NFL, and they all talk about the execution of play action. And all of them talk about the good ones, about taking their time and really working to sell the play action and sell the fake. If you don't take the time as a quarterback to really sell the fake, it's going to make it easy on the linebackers and safeties to realize that that was just a fake handoff and to get back in position. But when you really work it and sell it the way that quarterback did right there, that's when it's more effective. It can open up the big play.
He steps up. He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Second and 10, ball on the 40-yard line. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Open field. He's tackled in the open field. They come out in a five-wide set. Throws it. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. So a seven-play, 75-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Notre Dame yet set to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Across midfield, at the 30. And down he goes, around the 24-yard line. Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. And he's tackled at the 22-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Two ties.
Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 35.
From the 19-yard line, it's 3rd down. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's pushed out of bounds at the 8-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards.
Now here's the line.
That makes it 1st and goal.
Make the stop around the 7-yard line.
That brings up 2nd and goal.
2nd down, goal to go. Ball on the 7. So at the end of one, we're even at seven in this one. Even first quarter as we head into quarter number two. The PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. They'll bring him down at the 18-yard line.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Finds his receiver, who's all alone.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
He's into the open field. Tackle made around the 38-yard line. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Loss of two.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 36.
You ain't going nowhere.
Here he goes. Makes it out to about the 49. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
So after the review, they reversed the call on the field from their own 49-yard line. Second down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's taken down at the 42-yard line. They'll knock him down for a loss. The quarterback tried to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
This is a great punt blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. Hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Nebraska is up by a touchdown. Makes it out to about the 30. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of nine.
That'll make it second.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. They'll spread the field with five wide. He's to the 40. Gets out to around the 45.
That makes it first and 10.
with room to work. He's knocked out of bounds around the 35-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35. Gets him open field. Gets out to around the 18.
That's a team of 17 on the play. First down.
He makes it out to maybe the 16-yard line. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home. Let's make these babies cry all the way back home. Check 59. Mike is 59.
He fights forward to about the 13. Nebraska is up 7. Hand off inside. Gets to about the 11-yard line. A yard, maybe 2 on the carry. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Nebraska is hoping to make this a 2-score game. Kicks away, and it's good. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 1. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. Fires out to his wideout. Brought down at the 44-yard line. The pass results in a first down.
I'll tell you, great call by the coaches on first down. It stretches the defense when they're expecting the run, and then they end up with another first down.
And he's taken down right around the 40. Kirk, he's really got a lot of confidence in his receivers.
Yeah, I think he does, but in this case, I think he just threw it up for grabs. He thinks his receiver can make the catch no matter how many guys are hanging on his back.
Scrambling around. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 40. And he throws it away. Zips it to the back. They'll bring him down at about the 31. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he nails the long field goal. So we've played 2 quarters. The Cornhuskers lead 17-10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler in Kirk Herb Street.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
Excellent kick. He's to the 20, at the 30, and he's taken down at the 34-yard line.
Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime have allowed these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Get to that quickly. Tackle at the 42. He's at midfield. He's tackled at about the 43-yard line. There he goes. Nice gain as he works to the right side.
Gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Down he goes around the 31-yard line. He goes out of bounds right around the 28-yard line.
The corner is the toughest position to play in football. You have to be athletic enough to be able to run with wide receivers and willing to be able to come up and make plays like this to be able to stop the run. This is a big-time play by a corner, showing the versatility to be able to come up and be physical in the run game.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again. Nebraska is up by 4. He might have a chance. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 37.
Three down.
the middle for a nice gain.
That makes it second and six. Number four is in the quarterback.
Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. He tackles him for a loss. From their own 40-yard line, third down. The Cornhuskers quarterback down on the sideline after getting injured earlier. I think it looks like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we're going to see him back in the game before the day's over.
These guys were ready for the pass and played it well to come up with the deflection.
He puts it away, and it's a great kick. Tries to get around the corner. Tackle at the 17-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Throws out to the back, and it's through his hands. From their own 17-yard line, it's second down. He makes his way out to about the 25.
That's a game. That'll bring up 32.
15 to the night. I got 15. 8.
He makes his way to about the 38. He fights forward to about the 39. And run up the gut.
That's good for him. That'll bring up 34.
He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That's a gain of 2. That'll bring up 4th and 1.
Booming kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Nebraska holds a 4-point lead. Runs right for a nice game.
That'll make it second and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Check 59, Michael. Mike is 59. Michael 59.
He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. Decides to slide.
That's a game of 13. First down. Get out, get
out. Hey, look 48. That's down.
Slings it out there incomplete.
That pass led him just a little bit too far, but still, great effort.
That makes it 6-10.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled right around the 42-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up 36.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And they make the stop at the 40-yard line. From the 40-yard line, first down. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. 17-13, Cornhuskers. back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Nebraska is up four. Tackle made to the 38-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. He's taken down at the 33-yard line.
Called a gain of 5 yards. That makes it third and three.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
Three down. Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
He's tackled in the open field.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executed. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
There's a strike complete. Brought down at the 9. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Three down. Check 59. Mike is 59.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line. We're at the 12th play of the drive. He's scrambling. Dives, and he's down. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Nebraska is up by 4. Decent run here, right side.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That brings in second and goal.
From the 1 yard line, second down. They put everyone up on the line.
Get ahead of steam on that carry.
This is play number 15 of a very impressive drive. Touchdown, Cornhuskers.
You're that close to the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
And he hits the PAT. It was a 14-play, 81-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 22-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Got it and brought down immediately. For his man, incomplete. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Over the middle to his tailback. Very good tackle in space. They'll spread the field with five wide. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's taken down at the 43-yard line.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
And he's hit immediately. The catch and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. They've got one fourth down conversion on this drive. Now they'll give it another go. Catches it and he's looking for more. So a big, big stop on fourth down here late in the fourth quarter. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He might have a chance. Makes it to the 41. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. From the 43-yard line, second down. He'll go down to one knee. Nebraska's staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.